blessed evening, our dear brethren from Gospel of Grace.
Good evening po sa ating lahat. Nawa po ang Panginoon ay patuloy nating nakakasama sa pang-araw-araw po nating paglakad po sa pananampalataya. Ngayon pong gabing ito ay tinipon na naman po tayo ng Panginoon to pray for our country, for the concerns in our hearts, and to listen to His Word, and most especially, aawit po tayo sa Panginoon. Ang isang awit po na awitin natin ngayon ay it talks about the greatness of God. Ano po ba yung kadakilaan ng Panginoon? The greatness of God is seen in His creation. Kung paano po niya kinreate ang lahat ng mga bagay. At kung paano po niya tayo, tulad nga po ng topic ng Sunday, na ang Panginoon po ay mabuti sa atin at kahit sa araw-araw nating pamumuhay ay nararanasan po natin ang kabutihan po ng Panginoon. At ang pinaka-importante po sa lahat na expression ng kadakilaan at ng kabutihan po ng Panginoon ay when He sent His Son to save us from our sins. At itong awit na po ito ay patungkol po dito sa kadakilaan po ng Panginoon. The title of the song is How Great Thou Art. Let's come before the Lord and let's pour our hearts to Him. Let's give Him thanks for His goodness, for His loving kindness to us. Aming Amang nasa langit, maraming salamat po, Panginoon, na kami po ay binayayaan niyo naman ng Panginoon ng pagkakataon na dumapit po sa inyo at magbigyan po kayo ng papuri, ng pagsamba, Panginoon, na masamba po namin ang inyong pangalan. At binigyan niyo rin po kami ng time, Lord, ng moment na ito upang alalahanin namin, Panginoon, ang inyong kabutihan sa aming mga buhay. Lord, You are the all-powerful God. You are the God who created us. And apart from You, Lord, wala po kami dito, Panginoon. Hindi po kami, Panginoon, we will not be existing, Lord, because of You. And even You, O Lord, provide for all our needs, Lord. You provide for our clothing. You provide for our food, Lord. Kayo po, Panginoon, na nagbibigay sa amin ng lahat ng aming mga pangangailangan. Lord, napakabuti niyo nga po, Panginoon, sa amin. Na, Lord, bagamat kami po ay makakasalanan, Panginoon, ay patuloy niyo pa rin pong binibigay sa amin ang bagamat ang mundo, Panginoon, ay makasalanan, Lord, ay binibigay niyo pa rin po sa amin, Panginoon, ang lahat ng iyong pagpapala, Panginoon. Ngunit higit sa lahat, Panginoon, we thank You, Lord, for Your Son, Jesus Christ, for sending Him to die for our sins, Lord, to show us how You love us, Lord, by dying on the cross, to redeem us, Lord, from the eternal punishment of our iniquities, Lord. And because of this, Lord, we will indeed declare that You are good to us, You are faithful to us, You are indeed our Savior, our great Savior, our great God, and we will indeed, O God, continue to lift You up, Lord, Panginoon, in our hearts. And as we sing this song, Lord, we pray that You will continue to move in our hearts, that we would all the more realize Your greatness, O Lord, for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
sparing sent him to die. I scarcely take it in that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sins. Then sinks my soul, my Savior God. How great thou art, then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow, yes, Lord, in humble adoration, and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art. Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God.
Bless your name, Lord. We glorify you, O Lord. Salamat po, Panginoong Diyos, sa kabutihan niyo po, Panginoon, sa amin. Sa kadakilaan, Panginoon, niyo ng iyong pag-ibig, Lord. We glorify you, O God, indeed, Lord. Salamat po, Panginoon. And it is right and fitting, O Lord, for your people to gather together to tell, O God, of your greatness. And we pray, Lord, that tonight you will continue to move in our hearts, Lord. Na even sa aming pong pakikinig ng iyong salita, Panginoon, ay kikilos po kayo sa aming mga puso, Panginoon. That we will be thankful, O God, for your word that guides us, that sanctifies us, O Lord, with the help of your Spirit. Salamat po, Panginoon. We just commit to you everything, O God, tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Good evening po, mga kapatid. Praise God, tayo po muli ay meron pong another opportunity na magsama-sama po ngayon. Ngayong gabi po ay pag-uusapan po natin ang susunod na fruit of the Spirit, and tonight we will talk about the fruit of kindness. Let us turn to Galatians 5. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Again, such things, there is no law. Siguro po mga kapatid, lahat po tayo ngayon ay nanunubaybay ng mga balibalita mula po sa mga nangyayari po ngayon, lalong-lalo na po sa region po ng NCR. And I'm sure you've heard about the news that our president announced that the NCR will be again under modified ECQ. Mapapansin po natin, mga kapatid, na yung nangyayari po ngayon sa atin pong bansa mataas po ang emotions, mataas po ang tension ng mga tao. Ano po, with these new things, especially dahil nag-record high yung COVID cases po last Sunday. Nag-5,000 plus po yung COVID cases. So ang purpose po nitong MECQ na to ay mabigyan muna po ng rest yun pong ating mga frontliners dahil nga po sa influx ng mga COVID-19 patients. So hopefully, ito pong next 2 weeks ay ma-slow down po yung transmission po ng virus, no, sa nangyayari po ngayon sa NCR. Talaga pong nakakabagabag, nakakaawa po yung mga kababayan po natin po roon. Ano po, ito po ay isang bagay na dapat po talaga nating patuloy na ipanalangin sa Panginoon kung ano po ang magiging response po ng government po natin, ano po, ng iba't ibang sectors po ng atin pong country. Given po yung nangyayari po ngayon sa atin pong bansa, alam nyo po, what is really, really sad is the news that you read and hear that you have a lot of harsh words, ano po, and insensitive comments that you hear here and there, ano po, that you hear and there. And sometimes, they even come from our public officials. And we have to really keep praying that given the serious situation that we are in, we really do not need harsh words, no? We really do not need bickering and insensitive comments which can aggravate the already difficult situation that we are in. So, my dear friends, this is a time wherein Christians really need to continue to keep shining as salt and light. Bakit po? These are dark times and as Christians, hindi po tayo magiging part dito pong tension po na ito. Hindi po tayo magiging part ng pong bickering na nangyayari po ngayon, ano, na nagkakaroon ng blame shifting, na nagkakaroon po ng silipan, ano po, and all those things. As Christians, we need to shine as salt and light because the Lord has already shown us the way how to live by following His footsteps and all by the enabling grace of the Holy Spirit. Let us read Philippians chapter 2. Ang sabi rito, do all things without grumbling or disputing, that you may be blameless and innocent children of God without blemish, in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation among whom you shine as lights in the world, holding fast to the word of life. So my dear brethren, tonight we will be looking at kindness. And it is our prayer that far from being considered a burden, the spiritual fruit of kindness will first and foremost refresh our souls and clear the air in our hearts of worry, despair, and frustration. Sabi nga po, nung kaninang binasa natin na scripture, we would be like stars that are shining brightest where it is darkness. So, ano po ba ang kindness? Based on the book of Jerry Bridges on the fruitful life, first and foremost, kindness is an inner disposition. It is an inner disposition that is created by the Holy Spirit that causes us to be sensitive to the needs of others, whether physical, emotional, or spiritual. It is being aware of those around us and the thoughtfulness that we can express to them. Alright? So, ano po ba yung mga ways of showing kindness? Kindness may be as simple as a smile to a store clerk, a thank you to a waitress, an encouraging word to an elderly person, or a word of recognition to a small child. So, you would notice that kindness is really something that is internal. It is a disposition of a person to be kind and not harsh or insensitive. No? When a person is kind, he or she is simply overflowing with the peace and the calm that he or she has within. Ano po? So, you are a kind person because it is a reflection of one's disposition within. Ano po? So kung tayo po ay masungit, kung tayo po ay harsh and insensitive, it is simply a reflection ng disposition po natin sa loob ng ating pong mga puso. No? And maybe some of us would probably excuse ourselves and say, but I am not really a kind or a pleasant human being. no? Maybe we would say, that's just not my personality, no? So maybe we would say that we are not kind on the outside, but we are good people. But the problem is kindness is part of the fruit of the Spirit. So we cannot really say that we can be excused from being kind, all right? Sabi nga po ng isang author, kindness in our days today is underrated because we equate it with being nice, with being pleasant, as though kindness is just about smiling, it's just about getting along, and not ruffling feathers. It seems a rather mundane virtue. So it seems as if it is something that you can overlook, and it is really not that important to be kind. But then again, we see that kindness is included in the 9 virtues in the fruit of the Spirit. So first and foremost, it's an inner disposition. No? It is an inner disposition, and that is really something that only the Holy Spirit can produce. Amen? So if our disposition is not spiritual, if it is not something that comes from God's heart, from God's love, then it will really manifest, no, dun po sa ating pong pang-araw-araw. Ano po yung pangalawa? Kindness is a sincere desire for the happiness of others. Ang ganda po, ano? It is a sincere desire for the happiness of others. None of the expressions mentioned above, yung pong kanina sinabi natin, is costly in time or money. Totoo naman, di po ba? Yung maging kind, hindi naman nangangailangan na tayo po ay gumastos ng malaki. Alright? Hindi nangangailangan na tayo po ay mag-devote ng maraming oras. To be kind does not require us to be spending a lot of money. It does not require anything that is material from us. To be kind is simply a sincere desire for the happiness of others. And it is expressed, no? It is expressed in those little things on a daily basis. Most of us naturally tend to be concerned about our responsibilities, our problems, and our plans. So in other words, consume tayo ng ating pong mga sariling mga problems, sarili pong mga concerns, no? Sarili po nating mga pangangailangan, no? And all those things. But the person who has grown in the grace of kindness has expanded his thinking outside of himself and his interests. So, a person daw po na meron pong kindness sa kanyang puso, hindi lamang siya nakatingin dun sa sarili po niyang mga pangangailangan or sa sarili po niyang, no, world or sa sarili niyang concern. Yung kanyang mundo ay mas malaki other than himself. Yung kanyang mundo ay mas malaki other than the stress that he or she is going through. Bakit po? Because he or she has developed a genuine interest in the happiness and the well-being of those who are around him. So, ang ganda-ganda ng kindness kasi it is a selfless concern for others that you're not only thinking of your needs, your concerns all the time, but you are interested of how other people can be eased, how other people can be convenienced, how other people can be helped, no? How other people can be made a little cheerful or joyful, ano po? Kumbaga, gusto mong maging blessing, di ba? Gusto mong maging pagpapala na kahit sa maliliit na ways, no, ay makapagbigay ka ng pagpapala dun sa persons that we encounter on a daily basis. And my dear friends, during a pandemic like this, since we are all encountering difficulties, our tendency is to be self-centered and to preserve our own little normal in our own homes. Correct? No po? That is why kindness is spirit-produced because it calls for personal stretching and a greater sensitivity to others. Nowadays, we can easily excuse ourselves by saying, ang dami ko kasing iniisip, no? Ang dami ko kasing problema. And given po yun, legitimate po yun to be concerned with our own ano po, with our own needs, no, to be concerned with what we're going through. That is why kindness is a fruit of the Spirit, because it's out of the ordinary, it's out of the normal, because the flesh would really always gravitate to the self, no? But the Spirit would, what? Would help us go beyond ourselves and also have the sensitivity, ano po, or awareness dun sa ano yung needs ng iba. Like, I want to share with you po, no, recently, napansin niyo po ba na ang dami po mga black and white pictures ngayon, ano, na nakapost po sa social media. And maybe some of you have received this challenge to also post your black and white photo. I'm talking specifically to the women, ano po, and siguro nakareceive tayo ng ganito, no? And ano ba yung cause noon, ano? Ano ba yung purpose kung bakit kailangan mag-post ng black and white, no? And apparently, I found out that the main reason why these black and white photos have become a movement, it has something to do, guess what? It has something to do with what you call as the femicide that is happening now in Turkey. Femicide is a term that is used for the masses of women who are abused and murdered at the hands of their partners. Mabigat po pala yun, no? Femicide, mga babae na ina-abuse at pinapatay po. And this kind of domestic violence is happening rampant in Turkey. Women's rights activists have taken to the streets and are calling on the government to take a stand against the widespread domestic violence problem in Turkey. So the black and white photo was apparently meant to represent the victims of gender violence whose photos were broadcast in news media, all right? So what we're saying is that those black and white photos is actually pagluluksa dun sa mga namatay. Hindi po siya just empowering women, but it has something to do with mourning for those who were murdered. Can you imagine that? Now when you look at those black and white photos, you realize that the root cause of it have already been sort of lost in translation. That is why, my dear friends, we will find here that the real spirit of doing goodness and kindness is something that is really, really internal. It is something that cannot be posted through a black and white photo merely. Kindness and goodness is something that is a work of God in a person's heart. Otherwise, if it is just something that we can post, no? Just like this movement, the main reason easily got lost, no, when it began to spread. That's because the purpose to the goodness and kindness are things that are really eternal, no? Sabi nga po ng Desiring God, it is a supernaturally generous orientation of our hearts towards other people. Sabi po about kindness. Even when they don't deserve it and they don't love us in return. God Himself is kind in this way. His kindness is meant to lead people to repentance, which implies that they haven't yet returned to Him and are still His enemies. Ang natural inclination po kasi natin as people is to show kindness only to those that we like, our family, our friends, or those who are likable in general. But when we look at the example of our God, we look at the example of Christ, we find that God shows kindness to those who are most despicable. No, the despicable meaning those that are kasuklam-suklam, those na kagalit-galit. God shows kindness to the ungrateful and the wicked. So when you look at the example of God, sobrang layo, no? Dun sa na iniisip natin na kindness, we are looking at kindness in terms of being pleasant, no? Being sensitive and nice. But when you really look at the example of God, His kindness is brought to the highest level because He is kind to the despicable. He is kind to the ungrateful. He is kind to those who are wicked. Let me read to you some scriptures that show us the kindness of God. In Luke chapter 6, "But love your enemies and do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. And your reward will be great, and you will be sons of the Most High, for He Himself is kind to ungrateful and evil men." So here we find that it is very explicit about the nature of God to be kind to both the ungrateful and the wicked. And the scripture tells us to imitate the Lord, because that is who He is. And since we are His children, yun din po yung ine-expect ng Panginoon na magiging tayo, no? Dahil ganoon po ang ating pong Ama na nasa langit. In Titus chapter 3, another example that God is kind, not only to the likable. God is kind specifically to the despicable. "For we also once were foolish ourselves, disobedient, deceived, enslaved to various lusts and pleasures, spending our life in malice and envy, hateful, hating one another. But when the kindness of God our Savior and His love for mankind appeared, He saved us not on the basis of deeds which we have done in righteousness, but according to His mercy." So napakaganda po nito, mga kapatid, na pinakikita po rito what we were like before. We were once foolish ourselves. We were disobedient, deceived, spending our life in malice and envy. But it says, "But when the kindness of God our Savior and His love appeared," no? Referring, of course, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who came into this world in order to be the ransom for our sins through His death on the cross. Now, maybe the question now for us is, have you ever tried to be kind to someone who was ungrateful? Ano po? Have you ever tried to be kind? And to be honest, it is hard to answer this question, no? It is hard to answer this question because oftentimes we harden towards a person who has been ungrateful. We harden towards a person who did us evil. Ano po? Usually, ganun po yan eh. Di po ba? Talagang tumitigas po, lumalamig po yung heart natin towards a person who is ungrateful. Okay? Sabi nga ni Jerry Bridges, "Unless God's grace was working in your heart in a significant way, your reaction to the ingratitude may well have been, 'I'll never do anything good for that person again.'" Correct? No? Dahil naka-experience tayo ng, no, ng something bad, iniisip natin, hindi ko na siya gagawa ng kabutihan. But God does not turn His back on the ungrateful. That is why God's loving kindness leads sinners back to repentance. Napakabuti po ng Panginoon. Napakaganda po ng kanyang, napakaganda at napakayaman po ng kanya pong pag-ibig. Our kindness, of course, will therefore reflect the Father heart of God. Amen? Our kindness would reflect the Father heart of God. Because God has a fatherly love towards His creation. He has a fatherly love towards men in general, no? Towards people in general. So when we are kind to the ungrateful and the wicked, no? When we imitate, when we love our enemies and pray for those who mistreat us, we are reflecting the kind and the fatherly love of our God. Let me read to you Ephesians 4:32. "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other just as in Christ God forgave you." Now, my dear friends, having said this, we may mistaken kindness to be always ano po, being nice and pleasant, and it's just limited to it. But in the Bible, it tells us that kindness can also mean, all right, it can also mean that we would have to correct or rebuke a person, and the Bible still considers that kindness. Saan po natin yan makikita? In Psalm 141 verse 5, here we will see that kindness may really feel more like a blow to the head, because it says here, "Let a righteous man strike me, that is kindness. Let him rebuke me, that is oil on my head." Okay? So, it's like you wearing a shirt the wrong side, and we say that out of the kindness of a stranger pointed it out that we are wearing our shirt the wrong side. Ano po? Now, we say it's out of kindness because a person risks a lot to be able to tell us that we are wearing our shirt the wrong side. No, he or she is risking a lot kasi po pwedeng magalit ka sa kanya, po pwedeng bulyawan mo siya, no, sigawan mo siya for telling you that you have your shirt the wrong side, no? But a person will do it even though there may be risks or consequences for having said it. So the Bible tells that that is actually a kind thing to do, all right? Jesus called the Pharisees a brood of vipers. That was not pleasant, but it was kind. Why? Because Jesus was exposing their sin. A kind physician cuts deep in order to get your cancer. Kung cancer, of course, iba naman po yung pagiging judgmental, no? Iba naman yung pagiging critical spirit. These are the things that we discussed a few weeks ago, no? Pero yun na nga po. Sometimes, kindness is being able to tell the truth, especially if, kumbaga po sa sakit, it's already serious, it's already cancer, and it can already cause a person to be harmed or be hurt in a very serious way. We need to develop kindness as an inner disposition. We need to be sensitive to others and truly desire their happiness. Now, sensitivity alone, according to Jerry Bridges, however, is not enough. We need the grace of goodness, which impels us to take action in order to meet those needs. Goodness is going to be the next in the fruit of the Spirit after kindness. So we will be talking about goodness next Thursday po. So sa oras po na to, handa po natin ang puso po natin sa pananalangin po sa Panginoon.
Tayo po ay lumapit po sa Panginoon upang ipanalangin po natin ating bansa. Amang nasa langit, kami po ay patuloy na umihiling, Panginoon, sa inyo ng inyo pong pagsagot sa aming pong mga panalangin, ipapanalangin ngayong gabing ito, Panginoon. Lord, first and foremost, we pray for unity, O Lord, in our government. We pray for unity, Lord, amongst those who are running our country and with those who are with our frontliners, Lord. Panginoon, dalangin po namin na magkaroon po ng pagkakaisa, Panginoon, na isang mithiin lamang, Panginoon, ang bawat grupo na ito, Panginoon. Dalangin po namin na, Lord, nakita po nila ang pangangailangan mag-cooperate, Lord, upang maayos, Panginoon, magkaroon po ng lunas, Lord, magkaroon po ng solution, Lord, ang pag widespread po, Panginoon, ng aming pong condition, ng aming pong COVID infection dito po sa aming bansa, Panginoon. Lord, dinadalangin po namin na kayo po, Panginoon Diyos, ang kumilos sa bawat puso, Panginoon, ng aming pong mga government leaders, Lord, especially in our President's heart, Lord, na siya po ay hindi po maging Panginoon, reactive, Lord, sa mga comments na naririnig niya, Panginoon, against how things are being done, Panginoon. And we pray, Lord, that we pray for a heart of humility, Panginoon, for those who are in our government, Lord, that they would not, they would hear things, Lord, Panginoon, being said against what's going on, Panginoon, as something that is good for them, Lord, for there should be, Lord, Panginoon, a common consensus, Panginoon, sa kung ano po makakabuti, Panginoon. At nangangailangan po, kailangan po, Panginoon, ng bawat isa, O Lord, ang tulong ng bawat isa. At dalangin po namin, Panginoon, that you will continue, O God, to unite our leaders, oh God, our health workers, Lord, in coming up with guidelines or programs, Lord, or ordinances, Lord, that would really help our country, Panginoon, in this pandemic, Lord. We ask, Lord, that patuloy niyo pong bigyan lamang, Panginoon, ng karunungan ng aming bawat isa sa kanila, Panginoon, upang nakita po nila, Panginoon, ang kung ano po ang makabubuti, Panginoon, para po sa aming bansa. At dalangin po namin, Panginoon, ang patuloy ang aming pong mga frontliners, Lord, that you will continue to move, O God, in their service. Lord, we pray that, Lord, you will grant them strength. You will grant them, Lord, perseverance, Lord. You will grant them, O God, compassion for our patients, Lord. We pray, O God, that you will continue, Lord, to bless their hearts. And we pray, Lord, that they will call upon you, Panginoon, that they will see that they cannot do their daily challenges, Lord, in life, in their hospitals, apart from your grace. And we pray that they would learn, O God, to pray to you, Lord, and come to you, O Lord, with humility. We pray, O Lord, for your gospel, O God, to penetrate their hearts, Lord. We pray, O God, for the things, O God, that they are doing, Panginoon, in attending the patients, Lord, that you will grant them wisdom as to how they will be doing, will effectively treat, O God, their patients, Lord. We pray for the patients, O God, Panginoon. We ask, O Lord, that you will heal them, O God. We believe, O Lord, that there are about 36,000, Panginoon, who are already active, Lord, in active cases, Lord. We pray, O God, that you will move, O God, in their situation, that even in their Panginoon sickbed, Lord, they will call upon you, Panginoon, that you will heal, O God, them. There, that they will see that you are their only hope, O God. Dalangin po namin, Panginoon, that this will turn, O God, to be a defining moment for them, Lord, to get to know you, O God, to know you personally as their Lord and Savior. We pray, O God, na kayo po, Panginoon, ang kumilos, Lord, sa sitwasyon na ito, Panginoon, that you will, your sovereign will be done, Lord, in this aspect, O God. Dalangin po namin na patuloy niyo pong, Lord, kilusan ang bawat isa, Panginoon, na mas marami pa ang makakilala po sa inyo, Panginoon. At dalangin po namin ang mga kababayan po namin sa Metro Manila, Lord. Lord, you know, O Lord, how difficult their situation, Panginoon, there. And we pray, O God, kayo po, Panginoon, ang patuloy lamang na magbigay ng pag-asa sa kanila. Lord, marami pong mga kababayan namin, Panginoon, mahihirapan na namang baka pumasok, Panginoon, sa kanilang mga trabaho dahil po wala silang transportation, Panginoon, provisions, Lord. We pray, O God, for them that you will, Panginoon, calm their hearts, O God. Grant them peace, Lord, na, Panginoon, na kayo po lamang siyang kumilos sa kanilang mga puso, Panginoon, at magtiwala nga lamang po sa inyo. Dalangin po namin, Panginoon, na you will continue to minister, O God, to those who have lost their jobs, Lord. We pray that you will indeed, O God, grant them hope, Lord. We pray for the gospel to reach them, Lord. We pray, O God, for the ministries of your churches, O Lord, that, Panginoon, we will be able, O God, to reach them out, Panginoon, and, Lord, so that they will hear the good news of Jesus Christ, Panginoon, so that they will have, Lord, hope, not just in this world, O God, but eternal hope, Panginoon, found only in Jesus Christ our Lord. Panginoon, maraming salamat po, Panginoon, na, Lord, bagkamat magulo, Panginoon, na aming kinilalagyan ngayon, kayo po, O Diyos, ay kumikilos, Panginoon, sa aming kalagitnaan. And you're assuring us, O God, that you are in control of our situation, O Lord. Salamat po, Panginoon. We just pray, O Lord, that you will continue to make manifest, O God, your presence in our midst, Lord, most especially in the midst of your church, Lord. All this we pray, Panginoon, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let's end po by singing a song unto the Lord. Alamitin po natin ang Think About His Love.
Think about His goodness. Think about
high as the heavens above, so great is the measure of our Father's love. Great is the measure of our Father's love. Think about His love. Think about His goodness. Think about His grace.
Opportunity, Lord, to have our online evening prayer watch. Father God, we also thank you, dear Lord, for your grace upon our lives, Lord God. Oh Lord, that teaches us, Lord, how we can be stars, oh Lord God, shining brightly in the midst of a dark world like ours right now. Father God, we continue to pray, Lord God, that you will be our light. You will be our guidance, Lord. You will show us, Lord, what is truth, what is pleasing, O God, in your eyes. What is, Lord, glorifying to your name, Father God. And Lord, we pray, Father God, that you will help us, Lord, to have a kind disposition, Father God, wherever we are, O Lord, in our homes, in our workplaces. Father God, here in our neighbor, Lord God, in our neighborhood, in our churches, Father, we pray, dear Lord, that you will help us to reflect the Father heart of God. We pray for the Holy Spirit, Lord, to soften our hearts. We pray for the Holy Spirit to give us, Lord, a kind and compassionate heart. Marami pong salamat, Panginoon. We entrust to you, dear Lord, the rest of the evening. We pray for your strength to be upon our brothers and sisters, O Lord God, who will be taking a rest. We pray for those, Lord, who, O Lord God, are encountering sickness, Lord. We pray for your healing touch upon them, Lord. Kilala niyo po ang mga kapatiran namin, Lord, na mga nakakaramdam, Panginoon, Lord, ng sakit sa kanilang mga katawan, Panginoon. And Father, we continue to commit to you, dear Lord, Father in heaven, your church, Lord God. We pray, Father God, for your upholding. We pray, Father God, for your strengthening. We pray, dear Lord, for the anointing of your Holy Spirit upon your people. That, Lord, in the midst of what's happening around us, Lord, Father, we will remain faithful, O God, in seeking your heart, in seeking your will, O Lord. We will remain faithful, O God, in staying true, O God, to your word. Maraming marami pong salamat, Panginoon. We pray for your peace, for your love, for your joy, Lord, to be upon everyone, O Lord, tonight. Marami pong salamat, Panginoon. We are careful to give you back all the glory, Lord, knowing, Father God, na kayo po, Lord God, ang makapangyarihan sa lahat. We know, Father God, na sasagutin niyo po, Panginoon, Lord, ang mga panalangin ito. You are in full control, O God, of the situation right now in our country. And we thank you, Father. We thank you, Father God, for we know, Lord, that you will show forth, O God, your goodness. You will show forth, Lord, your faithfulness, Lord. Father God, in these times, Lord, we believe you, Lord. We believe your word. We believe your mercies. Salamat po, Panginoon. We praise you again, O Jesus. We give you back all the glory and all the praises. In the most sweet and powerful name of Jesus Christ, we pray all this. Amen and amen. Good evening and good night po, mga kapatid. God bless po.